Welcome to Adventure Sport. Today's episode, Flashlight Batteries 101. Today we'll go over the basic battery types, cell chemistries, charging and discharging safety. I'll explain what the numbers on the batteries mean, and I'll also give you my brand recommendations. The most common types of batteries used in flashlights are lithium-ion and nickel metal hydride. Nickel metal hydride batteries typically come in sizes that are a direct replacement for alkaline cells, such as AA, C, and D. They run about 1.2 volts per cell, and they're a great replacement for alkaline batteries in most devices. Lithium ion is a term that encompasses several battery chemistries, but in the case for flashlights, most of those will be 3.7 volts. Let's talk about what the numbers on these batteries mean. On each of these, we have some common sets of numbers that you've probably heard. This one says 18650, and this other says 26650. The first pair of numbers in that series is the diameter, and the second pair is the length. You can also get lithium-ion batteries to replace common size cells like AA or CR123 batteries. A 14500 cell is equal in size to an AA, and a 16340 is equal to a 3 volt CR123. Just be aware that the lithium ion cells are higher in voltage than both of these, and not every flashlight can take that extra voltage. Fully charged lithium ion cells are 4.2 volts apiece. The next set of numbers we see here is the capacity of the cell. This key power cell has a capacity of 5200 milliamp hours, which basically just means if we were to discharge this battery at 5200 milliamps, it would run for 1 hour. Moving on to the letters, some of the common lettering you'll see in flashlight batteries is IMR, INR, ICR. And it's not really important that you know exactly what those chemistries mean. What is important is that you know how to treat them. IMR and INR are what's known as safe chemistry cells, and they're more forgiving than others. You can discharge them at a higher rate. The ICR are not a safe chemistry. That C means cobalt, or be careful. You can't just try stuff with these. If you do and you try the wrong stuff, they can vent toxic fumes or even catch fire. The best way to know how hard you can discharge a cell is to look at the manufacturer's specs. Looking here at the KeyPower 26650, we can see we have a maximum discharge current of 9.5 amps. Sometimes you'll see a rating that says 2C or 5C, and that just means 2 times the capacity of the cell. Looking at our LG 18650, we also see a 10 amp maximum discharge, or about 3C. Another important thing to note is the maximum charging current. For this cell, we can see that it's 3.1 amp or 1C. 1C is typically the maximum for most lithium ion cells used in flashlights. One other variation you've probably heard of in lithium ion cells is protected and unprotected. Basically, what this means is that there's a circuit that's been added to the end of the battery that will keep it from being able to be discharged to too low of a voltage. Doing that will definitely damage your batteries, and in this case, 2.8 volts is about the minimum you want. Protection circuits also protect the battery from being overcharged, and some of them will even protect it from being discharged at too high of a rate. Looking at these two cells, even though they both say that they're 65 millimeter in length, you can see that one is obviously longer than the other one. The KeyPower cell is longer because it has the protection circuit added, as well as having a button top raised on the battery positive end. Are you guys with me so far? Okay, pretty simple, hopefully. It gets even simpler as we move into nickel metal hydride. A quality set of these cells can be charged and discharged at a pretty high rate, much like the safe chemistry lithium ion cells, and they don't carry the risk of venting toxic fumes. Performance will vary greatly from brand to brand, but as a rule of thumb, I prefer the low self discharge type. Nickel metal hydride cells have a fairly high rate of self-discharge, meaning if you charge them up and then leave them and come back later, chances are they're either going to be low charge or maybe even dead. The LSD type cells can be stored for long periods of time and still maintain most of their charge. On to charging and brand recommendations. When charging any type of battery, it's preferable to get a quality charger for safety reasons. I would say one of the most important things to look for when choosing a charger is that it has independent charging channels. Most lithium-ion chargers have these, but a lot of the nickel metal hydride ones you find don't. I use the Nightcore brand chargers because they can charge both lithium-ion and nickel metal hydride cells. This D2 digital charger is one of my favorites because it can charge a pair of 26650s side by side. It even works with the longer protected cells. Something else you really want to watch closely is this. All of these batteries look similar, but fundamentally a few of them are very different. Some flashlights you buy now come with batteries already in them. Some of these are rechargeable lithium cells, and some of them are what's known as lithium primary cells. 1.5 volt lithium cells like Energizers or the 3 volt CR123 cells that you get in a lot of flashlights are not rechargeable. Now for brand recommendations. I like KeyPower cells a lot. They mark their batteries with realistic capacities. They're good quality, and they offer a lot of protected cells. I also like the eFest brand cells that I've tried. Probably the best resource I've ever seen for helping you pick what battery is best for you is the webpage that HKJ puts up. You can just Google battery comparator and find his site, and on there you'll see that you can find comparisons for almost any popular cell. And it's good quality information. He does independent tests that show what the discharge curves are for each battery and how high you can discharge them at, and just pretty much anything that you would need to know. For the nickel metal hydride cells, a lot of people stand by Eneloops because of their reputation for quality. Another cheaper alternative would be the Duraloops, as they're called, which is basically the Duracell pre-charged battery that has the white ring around the top, and they're made in Japan, not the black top ones that are made in China. Recently I found what I think is a good third option. It's the PowerX Imedion. They're a 2500 milliamp capacity cell. They're low self-discharge and they're a whole lot cheaper than Eneloops. They also performed pretty well under load in some of the tests that I found on the internet. For larger cells like C and D, I recommend Tenergy Centura for basically all the same reasons as the other batteries. One last thing we need to talk about is battery source or suppliers. The internet is just absolutely flooded with trash when it comes to these batteries. It's so easy to buy just junk or fakes, things like that. So make sure you buy from a reputable dealer. You want to avoid sites like Alibaba or AliExpress. Whenever you find really cheap batteries, there's a reason for it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. If you've enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.